Let's go line number 2. Good morning, Morris. You're on the air.
Good morning, Patty.
How are you?
Not bad. I'd like to talk to you about one of the topics in your preamble this morning.
Okay.
And that's the letting of contracts to mainland companies, letting of contracts, of course, by Nalcor to mainland companies and offshore companies.
Yeah, it's not just Nalcor either. We have an awful lot of contracts that are left by the government that are won by out-of-province contractors. I wonder aloud how many locals actually get the opportunities that we should be getting.
Now, I'm using the word Nalcor, but I think most of the contracts that Nalcor is letting is done, somebody said up to 90% is done by SNC-Lavalin. But Nalcor and the Minister of Industry through the, or the government through the Minister of Industry should certainly have more to say, of who's getting these contracts, as far as I'm concerned, it's a tremendous loss of wealth from the province. And to this degree, because when you have companies, it is nice. I mean, it's great to have these companies to come in and hire people, and we have people working and getting an hourly rate. But when Newfoundland Labrador companies, Patty, you know, when the companies themselves make money, you know, you get that reinvestment. You get that money, the reinvested back into the province. I mean, these companies, Newfoundland companies, then would build office buildings and then probably expand their business so they could become competitive. And maybe they could lose money as well, but they could also make money, because we've seen that happen over the years. For example, you take the Crosbys in St. John's. I mean, the Lundrikens out here in Cornerbrook over the years. I mean, you know, the Lundrikens sort of built Cornerbrook and the office buildings, and I know they're not in a great business today, but look what they meant for the West Coast, and Crosbys for the St. John's area. And here we are, and I think the straws for me, and of course your topic was very timely. Nalcor now has just let a contract to a Quebec company to do a forest inventory on the trees from across Newfoundland into Soldiers Pond, and Patty, that means basically counting the trees, okay? Counting the trees on the proposed transmission line. And I don't know if, you know, for us that have been in the forestry business here for 100 years with Grand Falls and Cornerbrook, can't count the trees on the transmission line. It seems like that's wrong as far as I'm concerned.
I have no idea, but sometimes I think we're quick to say that Nalcor has done something wrong because people don't like or trust Nalcor, when in fact we have very few instances where we can say that a contract was improperly let.
Well, no, I'm not arguing that point this morning. But we're just making some comments. I mean, here we are here in my area, two or three of contractors, woodland contractors. I mean, they've been working with Cornerbrook Pulp and Paper, or they work with Abitibi for years. They know the business. They have the harvesters. They have all of the equipment to cut the trees on those transmission lines. But yet we had to bring in a company from Nova Scotia to hit that up. So as a result, you know, these contractors around here are gone down there now. I mean, they're working down there now. But you know, the main contract is let to a Nova Scotia company, and I wonder, did our people have the opportunity to bid on these contracts? They're darn well capable of doing the work, because they're doing it now,
mm-hmm.
but it, you know, we, well, as I said earlier, if a company makes some money, then you get it reinvested in our community here or in Newfoundland in general. And I mean, it's only a few years ago, a friend of mine, you take, I don't know if you've heard him in St. John's, Fraser Edison, he headed up a company or helped to head up a company in St. John's that built the GPS out in Bull Arm, and that was a Newfoundland company. And look what these companies, that company meant for the St. John's area in general, because there's all kinds of spin-off jobs. When a contractor, a business gets a contract, I mean, there's so many other areas, the spin-off jobs, other than the direct job that they have, even the office staff and even down to a janitor. It means a tremendous amount. And then, of course, when these contracts are done, the Nova Scotia company or the Alberta company says, thank you very much, I got my bit of money, and I'm gone.
Yeah.
And we're left with basically nothing.
Maybe. It's oversimplified, but I understand your point.
I know it's oversimplified, but you know where I'm coming
from. Yes, I do. I understand
that,
100%.
We have to have business, and it's great that the business is down there, is going ahead, the money is being spent, and we have, as a province, we have to maximize on everything that we can get in order to keep things going in this province, even after Muskrat Falls or anything else is completed, even up in Bull Arm today. It's great to have Newfoundland companies that's making money, reinvesting their money into various communities, and a lot of these companies, local companies, they contribute to the various charitable organizations around, maybe the Alberta company might as well, but not to the degree that the Newfoundland companies support their local communities.
Possibly so, Morris, and we all need to know how the tender process is working for companies there, not just at the provincial government level where they control the contract and the tender process, but also at Nalcor, which we know falls outside the tender process as we're familiar with. I'm taking one more call before we're done, but I always appreciate your time, sir.
All the best.
Take care.
Bye-bye.